When you click on a video title like The Secret to Human Development, you probably expect that I'm going to talk about some life hack like meditation retreats or speed reading or pills, supplements, superfoods, mnemonic devices, or some other amazing shortcut to personal growth. Well, I'm sorry to burst your bubble, but all of those are just short-term hacks that might be good for a little boost of productivity, but will not help you achieve sustained and efficient long-term success. You see, there really is only one guaranteed growth tactic for human development, and that is spaced repetition. In this video, I'm going to show you how you can harness that concept to improve your studies, improve your mental outlook, and even improve your physical capabilities. So if you're looking for the ultimate toolkit for leveling up in life, keep watching. I'm Andrew with Brainscape, an adaptive flashcards app built on decades of proven cognitive science research into how we learn better. And we've found time and time again that no learning technique or principle comes even close to being as effective as optimizing the spacing between each repetition of the thing that you're studying or practicing or learning. In other words, for something new that you've just learned, you practice it really frequently before you forget what you were taught. And for things you already know well, you practice less and less frequently because you'd otherwise be wasting your time doing something that you're already good at, rather than attacking your weaknesses, which is the way that we grow. That's it. This art of waiting until just the right stage of forgetting before repeating something is literally the way that our brain cells know how much more strongly they should connect to each other. I'm convinced that the human race is still less than 1% of the way toward optimizing our learning and development by incorporating spaced repetition into all parts of our lives and our education. And there's so much more innovation in technology and childcare and education that we'll be leveraging this principle in the years ahead. But for now, I promised you some advice for improving your learning and your personality and your fitness with existing spaced repetition tools. So here we go, starting with your learning. The key thing to remember here is that if you're gonna use spaced repetition effectively, you first need to be able to chop your goals into the most specific and repeatable sub-skills that you can deliberately isolate and repeat as needed. Let's say you're learning to play guitar. If you want to get a new chord transition or riff perfect, you'll probably need to repeat it like 100 times before you get it down perfectly. Then you should ideally practice it again 30 times in, say, an hour from now while it's still relatively fresh, or else you'll otherwise forget it. Then you could probably get by practicing it just 10 more times tomorrow, then 5 times next week, and finally at least once a month before the new guitar technique has become fully internalized and part of your personal routine. Of course, I made up these specific numbers for illustration purposes, but the point is you can't learn anything new unless you are systematically refreshing the foundations of everything you have learned before through the right pattern of repetition. This is the whole premise of spaced repetition, and it's also the reason why Brainscape flashcards are so effective. When you see each flashcard's answer in Brainscape, you are constantly rating your confidence in how well you knew the concept so that Brainscape can determine exactly how soon to quiz you on that flashcard again, and thus continue giving you guidance on when and how to space out your study sessions over time. The spaced repetition in Brainscape or in any other type of learning or study activity is the most effective way to maximize that strengthening of your neuron connections within the shortest amount of time. But spaced repetition ain't just for learning. As I mentioned earlier, you can also use spaced repetition to improve your mindset and your personality. Think of how many times you may have told yourself that you're no longer going to complain or get angry at the little things or get jealous or get anxious or brag or doubt yourself or any other number of psychological traits that you've been trying to work on. Every New Year's Eve, right? Changing your deep-seated mental patterns is hard because they've been hardwired inside your brain since you were a kid. So when you commit yourself to some behavior or exercise that will improve yourself up here, you might have to front load that practice and not taper off that practice until you know it's becoming a habit. Space repetition of personal habits. For example, let's say that your shrink convinced you that one of the best tools to get out of your current mental rut is to practice gratitude, which, by the way, is indeed one of the best things that you could ever do for your brain. To make that a real permanent habit, you might just need to start by practicing gratitude 100 times today to start upping it to the top of your mind. I'm not kidding. Set a timer to go off every 10 minutes to remind you to give thanks for all the amazing things that you do have in your life. Then tomorrow, maybe you can reduce that timer to every hour. And finally, once gratitude is in your bones, you can consider just doing it once a day. Like maybe when you brush your teeth or pray before bed, you associate it. But by that point, through the power of space repetition, the practice has likely become so internalized that you're actually subconsciously practicing it all the time. You're a gratitude machine and you're a happier and more likable person because of it. Speaking of good habits getting into your bones, that's a great segue into the last huge area where spaced repetition can improve your life, and that's all the way down to your cellular level. This one you'll be familiar with if you've ever pursued a fitness goal of any kind. You'll know that you can't just do soccer drills for 48 hours straight and then turn into Pele for the rest of the year. Your muscle cells and fibers need smaller bits of consistent practice over time in order to eventually get good. Early on, you're probably gonna have to do those basic drills all the time before you could start tapering those off and doing more advanced soccer drills. While those earlier basic skills still need to get the occasional continued spaced repetition as just a byproduct of the soccer that you're still playing. But it's not even just muscle cells and muscle memory. Spaced repetition works all the way down to your microbiome, the bacteria that live in your gut, your digestive cells, and even your immune cells. For example, let's say you get a full dose of a certain vaccine today. You may need a booster dose in 6 months, but then you can wait another 10 years for the next booster, just kind of to remind your body of the resistance that it had developed in response to the vaccine's initial instruction. Just like Brainscape with flashcard-spaced repetition intervals, doctors have figured out the optimal period of time for that booster, which happens to be just before your body might have otherwise forgotten how to protect itself against that pathogen. I could go on with tons of other examples, but I hope by now that you have seen consistency with systematically expanding intervals of repetition is the secret to all biological growth, human and otherwise. Sure, you can combine spaced repetition with your favorite mnemonics or pills or study games or whatever, but unless you're getting those intervals of repetition right, you're not learning or developing as efficiently as you could be. If you like this advice, please remember to subscribe to this channel and check out the Brainscape Academy for tons of other solid tips on learning and productivity so that you can rise to any challenge.